हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, मायसेल्फ तहसीन शेख, वेलकम टू नागेश करजगी ऑर्किड चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ज्योग्राफीज लेसन नंबर 1, इंडिया साइज एंड लोकेशन। सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट टुडेज सेशन, टुडेज लेसन नंबर 1, व्हाई इंडिया। इन दिस ईयर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इंडियाज फिजिकल फीचर। फिजिकल फीचर मीन्स वॉट? फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी ऑफ इंडिया, लाइक वेन वी ऑब्जर्व इन अवर सराउंडिंग एरिया इन्वायरमेंटल रिलेटेड थिंग्स लाइक नेचुरल वेजिटेशन, वाइल्ड लाइफ, क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन, विथ दैट आवर सराउंडिंग एरियाज फिजिकल फीचर, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ फिजिकल फीचर वी आर ऑब्जर्विंग, लाइक सम एरियाज आर मेड फ्रॉम फ्लैट एरिया, सम माउंटेन्स आर हियर इन इंडिया। वेन वी डिस्कस अबाउट द माउंटेन्स एंड प्लेन, प्लाटूज आर ऑल्सो ऑकर्ड इन द सदर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया। सो दिस टाइप ऑफ वराइटीज ऑफ लैंड फॉर्म्स, नेचुरल वेजिटेशन, वाइल्ड लाइफ विथ दैट क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन, different type of rivers and the population. So due to that region, the physical geography we are going to study in the lesson number, this lesson and in this full whole year. And in India size and location, India is our country and India's physical feature, India's size and location. India is located in the Asia and the location of India in the southern side and surrounding nations of India, India's water bodies, water area, these all part we are going to study in the lesson number 1. So students, let's start with our lesson first, India size and location. See here, India is one of the ancient civilization in the world. It has achieved a multifaceted socio-economical progress during the last 5 decades. So, we got freedom in 1947 and from 1950 to still now, from last 5, 6 to 7 decades, we are developing our India and our India's economical progress also, very social and economical, both type of progress also started, and due to that region, India has very traditionally, culturally diversified country. It has moved forward displaying remarkable progress in the field of agriculture, industry, technology and overall economic development. So when we come to the freedom after 1947, our India, it was depend on agricultural sector, but nowadays India developed in the field of industry, in the field of service, with agriculture, technology, science, skill, these all varieties of things are also developed in India. And now India has also contributed significantly in the making of world history. So see, first one we are going to study about the location. See students, map is here, this globe map. Now on when we come to the location, how one country's location we decide? First one, see here, our country is full here, our world, this center line here, it is called equator. यहाँ पे देखो, exactly जो center पे line दिखाई दे रही है, it is called equator. And this equator divided our globe in 2 part. The northern part of equator, it is called north hemisphere, and southern part of equator, it is called southern hemisphere. See, exactly center line, it is called zero latitude, or it is called equator area. And this equator divided our globe, northern part of equator, from 0 to 90 north, it is called northern hemisphere, and 0 to 90 south, it is called southern hemisphere. See, 0 to 90 here, it is called northern hemisphere, and 0 to 90 south side, southern hemisphere. Now when we come to the longitude, exactly center longitude, it is called prime meridian. See here, this is 0 means prime meridian, and from 0 to eastern side, here it is called eastern hemisphere, and from 0 to western side, here it is called western hemisphere. Means students, our globe due to equator and due to prime meridian divided into 4 section. Yahan pe ye pehla jo part hai, northern and eastern hemisphere, here northern and western hemisphere, in the southern side southern and western hemisphere, and here southern and eastern hemisphere. Okay, southwest, here first one, northeast, southeast, southwest and northwest. Okay, so on the basis of this latitude and longitude, now we are going to discuss about the country's location. So see, North America is located in the northern and western hemisphere, right students? Yes. So see, in the South America, located in the southern and western hemisphere. When we come to the Asia, majority of the part of Asia is located in the north and eastern hemisphere, and Australia, whole Australia is located in the south and eastern hemisphere. So, on the basis of latitude and longitude, see our India is located here, equatorial se thoda upar India, this yellow color. So, location see in the detail, India is vast country lying entirely in the northern hemisphere. See, equator is here and India is located exactly whole fully in the northern hemisphere. The mainland extend between latitude 8 degree 4 minute north and 37 degree 6 minute north, and longitude wise 68 degree 7 minute east and 97 degree 25 minute east. See here, that is southern portion, Kanyakumari is the part of Tamil Nadu's Kanyakumari. Andaman and Nicobar Islands are also there, and the southern portion is located on the 8 degree 4 minute north. And when we come to the northern part of India, yes, Jammu Kashmir is there, Srinagar, Jammu Kashmir, Union Territories are there, and this northern part is under the 37 degree 6 minute northern hemisphere. Okay, means yahan se jaise hum jayenge, this is north hemisphere. Now, on the basis of longitude, see, longitude means what? We are studying about the globe here vertically. Ab yahan pe agar aap dekhoge, first part, Gujarat, see here, after 60, 90, Gujarat is here, and Gujarat's location 68 degree 7 minute east to here 97 degree 25 minute east Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, means from here to here near about 30 longitude, and from north to south near about again 30 difference of 30 latitude. See students, so after 68 is here, and after 90, 97 or 98 degree 25 minute east. So this is called location of any countries, we find out through this latitude and longitude only. So see next part, the Tropic of Cancer 23 degree 30 minute north divided the country into almost two equal part. To the southeast and the southwest of mainland lie Andaman and Nicobar Island and the Lakshadweep Island in the Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea respectively. Find out the extent of this group of island from your atlas. See students, when we come to the Indian map, see here, Andaman and Nicobar in the Bay of Bengal and Lakshadweep Islands is a part of Arabian Sea, and with that our India's exactly from center of our India passes Tropic of Cancer 23.5 pe Tropic of Cancer pass hota hai, and this Tropic of Cancer divided our India into two section. North part of Tropic of Cancer, it is called North India, and south side of Tropic of Cancer, it is called South India. So the southernmost point of India, it is called Indira Point, got submerged under the sea water in 2004 during the tsunami. So, southern part, it is called Andaman and Nicobar southern part, Indira Point, and it was totally submerged under the water at the time of 2004 tsunami. Jo 2004 mein tsunami aayi thi, and under that tsunami, that Indira Point is totally submerged under the water. Now, the size of India, okay, just we have discussed the location on the basis of latitude and longitude. India is located in the whole northern and eastern hemisphere, and we have discussed about the location on the northern and eastern hemisphere. Now, next one we are going to study India's size, okay. The landmass of India as an covered area of 3.28 million square kilometer, and India's total area account for about 2.4% of the total geographical area. See, when we come to the India's size from north to south, means Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari and Assam to Arunachal Pradesh, 3.28 million square kilometer area is covered by our India. And when we come to the globe, when we compare to the globe, 2.4% area is occupied by our India in the globe. See on the next page, area of the world, means we compare to the world, 2.4% area is covered by our India, and when we come to the whole India, from north to south, east to west, near about 3.28 million square kilometer area is covered by our India. From figure 1.2, it is clear that India is the 7th largest country of the world, and India has a land boundary of about 15,200 kilometer, and total length of the coastal line of the mainland including Andaman and Nicobar and Lakshadweep 7516 kilometer. So student, see here figure 1.2, see here, this is figure 1.2. So when we observe this figure, largest country in the world, Russia, and near about 17.9% area, a million square kilometer area is covered by Russia. Ye dekho yahan pe. So sabse badi country Russia, second largest country Canada 9.98, third largest USA 9.83, fourth largest China 9.60, fifth largest Brazil 8.51, sixth one Australia 7.69, and seventh largest country in the world on the basis of area, it is India 3.28 square kilometer. And when we see the Indian map, see here India's map students, in the map here, from here to here means Gujarat to West Bengal, near about 15,200 kilometer land boundary. Ye dekho, agar aap dekhoge yahan pe Gujarat, Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Myanmar, these all are the land boundaries, and 15,200 kilometer from here to here it is called land area. And when we come to the southern side, again from Gujarat to West Bengal with Andaman, Nicobar and Lakshadweep, near about 7,516 kilometer of coastal area we get in India in the southern side. So students, see the Indian map. Now India is bounded by the Younger Fold mountain in the north and northwest, and north to northeast. See India's northern part here in the Jammu Kashmir, Nepal and Assam and Arunachal Pradesh part, from northwest to northeast is totally covered by, bounded by Younger Fold mountain. Himalayan mountains are located in the northern part, and south of the about 22 degree north latitude it begins to taper. See students, here this is 20 latitude, okay, after 22 latitude means from here it start to begin taper hona means triangular shape. See here in the southern part India is totally triangular, so in the 22 degree latitude it's become triangular, is become taper, and it extends southern side toward the Indian Ocean. Indian Ocean is here, and from here to here it extend totally in the taper shape, in the triangular shape, dividing it into two seas, Arabian Sea and the on the west, and Bay of Bengal in the east. See here, Arabian Sea, it's a part of our India's coastal area located on the western side, and Bay of Bengal, it's a part of India, it is located on the eastern margin of India. So this is the size of India. Look at figure 1.3, figure 1.3 means here India's map. Note that latitudinal and longitudinal extent of mainland is about 30 degree. Despite this fact, the east-west extent appear to be smaller than the north and south extent. So when we compare to the south and north extent, north and south extent is more than east and west extent. See students, 3,214 kilometer from here to here, and 2,933 kilometer from east to west. See here, this line connect Gujarat to Arunachal Pradesh, okay. Gujarat to Arunachal Pradesh 2,933 kilometer, and from north to south it is 3,214 kilometer, means compared to east to west, north and south is larger. See, from Gujarat to Arunachal Pradesh there is a time lag of 2 hours. Arunachal Pradesh here, it is located on eastern margin, and when we come to the eastern margin, sun rises first here on the eastern side, and it takes 2 hours to come in the Gujarat area. Dekho, sun rays jo hai wo agar 4 o'clock pe on the Arunachal Pradesh, so it takes 2 hours to come on the Gujarat area means near about 6 o'clock sunrays are appear in the Gujarat. Why? Because of the location. So Arunachal Pradesh is a forward in the eastern side, and due to that region the sunrays or the time lag is 2 hours time lag of our India. Hence time along the standard meridian of India, it is 82 degree 30 minute east, passing through Mirzapur in Uttar Pradesh is taken as the standard time for the whole country. The latitudinal extent influences the duration of day and night as one moves from south to north. See, when we come to the time lag, now here Assam and Arunachal Pradesh 2 hour time lag is there, but this line, this is 82 degree 30 minute line, it is called Mirzapur, and this is prime meridian of our India, IST, Indian Standard Time. And on the basis of this IST, our northern states and our southern state, our eastern state and our western state, we both are following the time which is totally set on the prime meridian. It is IST, Indian Standard Time. So I am standing here in the class. So in the my eastern side Arunachal Pradesh, and on my western side Gujarat is there. Sun rises in the eastern side at that time before 2 hours, and when it comes to the Gujarat it takes 2 hours. So due to that region, the center point of our country means jaise hi hamare country ke center point mein exactly 12 noon means sun rays are vertical exactly on the 12 noon, and that located or that location is called Mirzapur in Uttar Pradesh, is the center position of India, and it is located on 82 degree 30 minute east latitude. And on the basis of that, eastern countries and western countries, they both are following the middle timetable, and this timetable we are utilizing for railways timetable, our buses, they are moving, our whole country we are following the same time which is based on IST, Indian Standard Time. So students, clear why the standard meridian? To set our Indian watch we required standard meridian. See, in the next part, now next we are going to study India and the world. See here, now when we come to the India's location on the latitude and longitude, we have discussed the India's location on the basis of north and south, we have discussed about the India's size. Now India and the world, the Indian landmass has the central location between East and the West Asia. India is a southward extension of the Asian continent. The trans-Indian ocean routes which connect the country of Europe in the west and the countries of East Asia provide a strategic central location to India. Again, see here globe. Dekho, in the Asia, India is located exactly in the center. When we come to the Asia, see here, India is on the central position. Here, West Asia, here, East Asia. And when we want to go in the eastern side, Bay of Bengal is here. And when we want to go here on the western side, European countries ko jana hai, Africa jana hai, so hum jayenge through Arabian Ocean, Arabian Sea. And when we want to go for Australia, Japan or some Southeast nations, we are going through the Bay of Bengal. So India's strategic position, and it's very good, or it's helped India to water transportation. We are importing and we are exporting varieties of commodities through waterway, and due to Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean, we can import and export very, very easily. And see, India's location in the Asia is located in the southern side, and same central position to the West and East Asia. So see, next part, it's a provide strategic central position and thus helping India to establish close contact with West Asia and with the Africa and Europe, and in the eastern side with some Southeast Asian countries. No other country has a long coastline on the Indian Ocean as India has, and indeed means our India near about 7516 kilometer water area, we having coastal area. And when we compare to other countries, no other countries has that type of water coastal area. See, it is India's eminent position in the Indian Ocean which justify the naming of an ocean after it. When we come to the four ocean, Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Arctic Ocean and Indian Ocean. So after our country, it named as a Indian Ocean. अगर आप पैसिफिक देखोगे, no countries like Pacific, no Atlantic country, no Arctic country, but Indian Ocean and Indian country. So named after India, one of the major ocean located in the southern side, and as name of our country India, it is called as Indian Ocean in the southern side. See on the next part, again our India's map, we are going to discuss about our neighboring countries. Okay, see, India's contact with the world have continued through the ages, but her relationship, see here on the third page, this map, when we come to the contact with the world have continued through the ages, but her relationship through the land route are much older than the maritime contact. The various passes across the mountain and in the north have provided passages to the ancient traveler, while the oceans restricted such interaction for a long time. When we come to the our contact, our India is very ancient country, and we are going outside, and some outer side they are also visiting our India. Nowadays we are using water transportation, but before that our land transportation, our land connection with other countries are much more older compared to water transportation. See, India is located here, and through passes, Himalayan area, we were moving in the Pakistan, Afghanistan, Turkmenistan, Iran, Iraq, yahan tak hum jo hai wo journey karte the. Our Indian citizens, they were moving through the passes, different passes were there, because mountains all are totally covered by mountain. Himalayan mountains are there, and due to that region, passes, through passes, it is called Silk Route. Silk route, why it is called silk route? Because China export silk material to Iraq, Iran through that route. It is, that's why it is called silk route. And wo silk route ke through we connected India, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Iraq and Iran, and it is called land oldest land route. But nowadays, due to water transportation, we are going through directly Arabian Sea to here, see, Yemen, Oman, then Suez Canal. When we come here near the Egypt, here it is called Suez Canal, and through Suez Canal we export or import varieties of commodities in our India. See, these routes have contributed in the exchange of ideas and commodities since the ancient time. Students, we all are eating pasta in our home. Okay, hum sare log pasta khate hai ghar pe. So pasta is a Arabic dish, is a Arabian dish, and is entered in our India through Arabic country. We all are eating potato. जो पोटैटो भी है वो भी अदर कंट्रीज की डिश है. वी आर ईटिंग अवर चाइनीज, वी आर ईटिंग समटाइम थाई फूड. सो नॉट ओनली गुड्स और कमोडिटीज, विद दैट देयर ट्रेडिशन, देयर डिशेस, देयर डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सोशल थिंग्स, वी आर ऑल्सो ब्रॉट इन अवर इंडिया, एंड दैट्स वाई अवर कनेक्शन विद अदर कंट्रीज आर मच ओल्डर कंपेयर टू वाटर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन और वाटर रूट्स. सी, the idea of the Upanishad and the Ramayana, the story of Panchatantra, the Indian numericals and the decimal system thus could reach many part of the world. The spices, the muslin and the other merchandise were taken from India to different countries. Not only we import material, our material like our spices of India, like our cotton, our clothes, our garments, we are exporting to other countries, and through this land transportation and water transportation, both play very important role in the transportation area. See, the on the other hand, the influence of Greek sculpture and the architectural style of dome and minar from west to west Asia can be seen in the different part of our country. Mughal, they entered in our India through Iraq, Iran, and they covered our Delhi's part, northern India. And when they entered in our India, they were built varieties of buildings like Taj Mahal, Gol Gumbaj, agar aap dekhoge to Qutub Minar. These all are the best structural ideas of Mughals. And when they entered in India, they started to build their own technology, their archaeology, their architectural style like dome, minars, and the influence of these structural things, it's entered from the West Asian countries. So now next part, we are going to study India's neighbor country. Okay, see here, India's neighbor countries in the northwestern part. Here, India, northwestern part, Pakistan, and second one, Afghanistan is here. We are sharing our land boundaries and water boundaries with the nations, with the countries. It occupies important strategic position in South Asia, and total in our India nowadays in your textbook 29 states are there. But when we come to the latest textbook, in the last year, that Jammu and Kashmir, it's also included in the union territories. So now students, 28 states and 9 union territories. See, in your textbook 29 states are there and 7 union territories, but no, recently in our India we made some changes and 28 states and 9 union territories and 2 union territories are increased, like Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh, and one state is decreased and it is called Jammu Kashmir. तो जम्मू कश्मीर को हमने स्टेट से चेंज करके यूनियन टेरिटरी जो है वो बना दिया है. सो 28 स्टेट एंड 9 यूनियन टेरिटरीज ऑफ इंडिया, एंड इंडिया शेयर इट्स लैंड बाउंड्री विथ पाकिस्तान एंड अफगानिस्तान. सी इन द मैप, वी आर शेयरिंग अवर लैंड बाउंड्रीज विथ, इन द नॉर्थ वेस्टर्न पार्ट, सी इन द इंडियन पोजिशन, साउथ, नॉर्थ, ईस्ट, वेस्ट. ओके, साउथ, ईस्ट, नॉर्थ, वेस्ट. इन द वेस्टर्न पार्ट, इन द नॉर्थ वेस्टर्न पार्ट, पाकिस्तान एंड अफगानिस्तान इज देयर. इन द नदर्न पार्ट, सी हियर, चाइना, नेपाल एंड भूटान, दिस कंट्रीज आर लोकेटेड ऑन द नदर्न साइड. म्यांमार एंड बांग्लादेश, सी म्यांमार एंड बांग्लादेश, दिस टूज आर लोकेटेड इन द ईस्टर्न साइड. एंड वेन वी कम टू द साउथ, द सी कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू आईलैंड हियर, अंडमान एंड निकोबार. See, Andaman and Nicobar and Lakshadweep, two islands are there, and due to this region, the Sri Lanka and Maldives, two countries, see here, Sri Lanka and Maldives, these two countries are located in the southern side. So when we come to the India's boundaries or India's surrounding countries, see, India is here, and in the northwestern side, Pakistan and Afghanistan, in northern part, China, Nepal, Bhutan. In the eastern side, Myanmar and Bangladesh, and in the southern side, Sri Lanka and Maldives. These states are surrounding countries of our India. So see, in the next part, these namely Tibet, Nepal, Bhutan, North and Myanmar, Bangladesh in the east, and southern neighbors across the sea consist of two islands like Andaman and Nicobar. Sri Lanka and Maldives, Sri Lanka is separated from India by Pak Strait. See here, this is narrow channel, and this narrow channel separated Sri Lanka from our India, and this narrow channel is called Pak Strait, P-A-L-K, Pak Strait, and the Gulf of Mannar. See, the Gulf of Mannar and Pak Strait is here, and due to this Gulf of Mannar, our India is separated from mainland, Sri Lanka is separated from mainland of India. While Maldives islands are situated in the south of Lakshadweep island, ye dekho, see here, Lakshadweep island, it's a part of India only, but when we come to the Maldives, southern side of Lakshadweep, Maldives islands are here. India has had strong geographical and historical links with her neighbors. Look at the physical map and Asia in our atlas and note how India stand apart from the rest of Asia. So students, what we have discussed, about the India's size and location. India is very vast country, not only on the basis of area, on the term of cultural, tradition, social, economical things also highly developed in our India. India is located in the northern and eastern part of globe. India's size, when we compare to other countries, near about 7th position, means on the basis of area, 7th largest country of our India is 7th largest country, and near about 3.28 million square kilometer area is covered by India. And we have also discussed about the India's neighboring countries, Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Sri Lanka and Maldives. These all are India's neighboring countries. In the next lesson, we will discuss our next point, students, this lesson over here, and as a homework, you should write your exercise in the CW notebook. And in the next session, we will discuss about our fourth lesson, that is climatic condition of India. Okay, thank you.